Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel and hope you're having a great day so far. For today's video, I'll be doing on this look here, which is just gorgeous glowing bronze skin, which I think is perfect for any summer occasion. So starting out with my skin, as you can see, I have quite a few blemishes at the moment, so I'm just looking to even out my skin, and I'm using the Dior Star Liquid Foundation on a damp beauty blender just until I get a nice flawless and even finish to my skin. So now that I've evened out my skin nicely, I'm just going to go in and conceal and brighten up my under eye area with the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in the shade NC20, and then I'm just going to blend that into the skin and over the eyelids with the Damp Beauty Blender. Now just to set the skin, I'm going to use my Bourjois Healthy Balance powder and just dust that all over the skin lightly to make sure that it lasts all day. To add some colour and dimension back to the skin, I'm just using this MAC Mineralized Skin Finish powder in the shade Medium Deep on a Eco Tools fan brush, and I'm just focusing that on the hollows of my cheeks but blending it up onto the cheekbones and then across my temples and the jawline. And this is just going to warm up the skin and give a lot more shape to the face. This step is optional, but to add a little bit more glow to the skin, I took this shimmery bronzer from Collection and just applied it over top of the darker powder that I previously applied to my face. And as you can see, it just gives a little bit more dimension as it has a bit of a shimmer and glow to it. Never one to skip highlighter, so for today I'm using the Bobbi Brown Bronze Glow Highlighting Powder and just applying that to all the usual places with my Bobbi Brown Sheer Powder Brush. The perfect pop of colour to this look, I'm taking the Clinique blush in the shade Ginger Pop and just applying that directly to the apples of my cheeks with this, again with the Bobbi Brown Sheer powder brush. For brows today, I'm using my usual favourite, which is the MAC Fluid Line Brow Gel Cream in the shade Dirty Blonde. And I love a good strong brow, but I've recently been trying to keep them just a little bit softer by applying less product at the beginning and the end, the sort of the tail end of my brow. Using my MAC Pro Longwear Waterproof Brow Set in the shade Toasted Blonde today to set my eyebrows in place. Now I know you're probably thinking that shade is way too light for my eyebrows, but I actually really like the way that it looks. It gives my eyebrows a little bit of texture and just lightens them ever so slightly. And then straight over top of that colour, I applied Creme Brulee, and this just adds a little bit more depth and warmth to the eye, and as you can see, just really builds up the colour a little bit more. And then on a smaller tapered blending brush, I took the shades Chickadee and Cocoa Bear and just sort of focus on the contour of my eye. You can see I've sort of taken it towards the bridge of my nose and then slightly winged it out towards the end of my brow. And as always with any look, you just want to make sure that the eyeshadows are nicely blended out and seamless. And then I just went in and defined the outer corners a little bit more with the shade Cocoa Bear, and this is just going to give you more of that cat eye effect. Next up, I took my MAC 239 flat shader brush and sprayed it with some Fix Plus and went back to that Bobbi Brown highlighter and just packed it all over the eyelid and in the inner corners of my eyes. Here I just took Cocoa Bear again on a pencil brush and I'm just connecting up the outer edge with my lower lash line, and I find that this just really pulls the look together. So now I'm just highlighting the brow bone and the inner corners of my eye with a really pale matte pink shade. To add some depth and definition to my eyes, I'm just taking this Stila dark brown eyeliner and adding it to my top and lower waterline. To create a feline flick to my eyes, I'm taking the Maybelline Master Precise Liquid Eyeliner and trying to create a wing as thin as possible, but we all know that when you're trying to match up your eyeliner, it ends up just getting thicker and thicker, so yeah, I did my best today. Next up, you just want to apply lots of coats of your favourite mascara top and bottom. And now I'm just applying my favourite nude lipstick to my lips, which is Bobbi Brown's Nude Pink. To finish off the eyes, I use the Manicure eyelashes in the style Miranda and then just set my face with some setting spray, and that's pretty much the look all done. Let me know what you think of my new background. I decided to change it up just for something different. Obviously, I've just got my bedroom in the background. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. It means the world to me. And subscribe if you haven't already. And thanks so much for watching, and I shall see you in my next video.